Well, coming up on our next City Line, milestones during the first year of life, a fabulous play area for kids, new news on SIDS, and also we've got Mickey Lester on the next City Line.
From Young and Charles, this is City TV Everywhere. Tonight, Missing Mystery.
Tonight, the boat is afloat.
Tonight, the big shots are back.
Here's the latest from the City Pulse News Team. City Pulse, tonight.
Good evening. Another agonizing night for an Ajax family with no word from their daughter. She went shopping on the weekend and hasn't been seen since. 22-year-old Charlene Gemottine of Ajax has been gone since Sunday afternoon. She was wearing purple track pants and a sweater, a black leather jacket, white runners. She lived with her parents and brother, and this just doesn't make sense.
Definitely a homebody, very close to her family, very out of character for her.
We'd like to know what happened. It was just straightforward. She was just going to leave here, do a little bit of shopping for a couple hours, and return back home. And she even asked us if we wanted to go with her. And since we just were out and came back home and were kind of tired, we declined.
Charlene's game plan was to come here to the Zellers Supercenter store at Victoria Park in Eglinton and Scarborough, and then down to High and Zell's at Warden St. Clair. It's the old family neighborhood. She was comfortable at these stores, and then back home for some family plans. Of course, we don't know whether she was seen here at these stores yet. She never made it home.
Durham detectives were flashing her photo and running down store workers in Scarborough tonight, not to mention hunting Dad's missing maroon minivan.
We've had no sign of the vehicle. It was her father's 1988 Plymouth Voyager van, Ontario license, 850-PRY. No sign of that vehicle at this point.
There's no conflict between us and my daughter, and it's just like an open family. Just to not have any reason makes me think that sometimes the worst.
Charlene's on some medication and diets for severe food allergies, but has been doing better with it. Durham Police, 683-9100, if you spotted Charlene or the missing minivan.
Hilbert says he's like any other parent, never figured this would happen to his family. He's off work this week doing his own searching and investigating. Police in Barrie looking for leads tonight in that horrifying triple murder. The victim's ID'd is 85-year-old Ellsworth Beers, his 22-year-old granddaughter Pam Constable, and her friend 28-year-old Scott Seabrook. Their bodies in Toronto this evening for autopsies. Robbery, the likely motive.
I can't say what was stolen or what might have been taken. Two persons were found bound hand and foot. And one person, yes, did have a scarf wrapped around their neck, but that's all I can say at this time.
We are strong, not in ourselves. We know a God that is able to sustain us, and this God gives us the strength we need.
Officers believe they are searching for at least two killers, and they're trying to reassure Barrie's 67,000 residents the city is still a safe place to live. But there is concern tonight regarding safety in our schools. Police looking for a man in three vicious washroom sex assaults, one on a six-year-old girl. Suspect description, Aboriginal, about 25'5", slim with straight short black hair. May have been wearing a purple sweater and dark blue denim jacket. Natalie Pujol says a police news release left a lot of questions unanswered.
The sexual assault squad refuses to speak to me about it.
Yeah, there's a very good reason for that. And that is that they're very intensely investigating this matter, and they're also going through information that they're getting from the public at this particular time.
My son, he told me, is a guy go inside to the basement, close to the washroom, and he find a little girl. I am very scared because the kids is too small.
The man struck between 1 and 5:30 last Thursday afternoon, all in the same area around Bathurst between Queen and Bloor. The first at Charles G. Fraser, then Ryerson Public and Central Technical Schools. Got a lead for police? Give the Sex Assault Squad a call at 324-6060 or Crime Stoppers at 222-TIPS. Let's see what the police are up to tonight. Over to assignment, and here's Dwight.
Thanks, Mark. The night side has been quiet for emergency services. It won't be a quiet drive if you're using the 400 tonight. Major closures, I'll show you why. Let's just take a look with our eyes MTO. Let me just punch it up for you. The colder weather is here, but the construction continues. 400 southbound between 401 and Jane Street is closed. All traffic must exit at the 401. No official word yet on when things will reopen. Should all be clear for the morning rush hour. Let's run over here and take a look at the junction now. Take a look at the 401. It's been busy for most of the night. A little heavier eastbound right now, but all in all, everything is in good shape. Pretty good night out there, Mark.
Okay, thanks very much, Dwight. Police needed in North York tonight as the curtain went up on Showboat, the most controversial musicals to come to Metro in some time. Pam Siegel is there live, Pam.